So welcome to exercise 9.2 on dbScan. We were given a data set and a certain set of epsilon and min points values, and we're supposed to perform dbScan using those epsilon and min points values on that data set. So let's just jump right into it. We start with epsilon 1.1 and min points 2, and going in alphabetical order, we start with A. Check what is an epsilon range of A. Add B and C to our seed list, check C, add D to our seed list, also make C a core point, and then go to B, make B a core point, and then to D and make D a core point. And we jump onto E, which ends up being noise. We make F, we add F as a new cluster because it has none of the previous points. In epsilon range, then add G to our seed list, check G, add H, and then check J and I. We then check K, which becomes noise, L, which becomes noise, and yeah, the last points M, O, R, T, Q, N, P, and S. Yep. So that's for epsilon 1.1 and midpoints 2. So, yeah. With midpoints 2, no border points. And here's our clusters. We then continue with epsilon 1.1 and midpoints 3. That makes A still a core point, C still a core point, and B still a core point, and also of course D. E remains a noise point. F becomes a noise point for the moment. We then check G. C, G is a core point, and therefore change F to a border point. Check H, which is also a core point. Then check J, which becomes a border point, and I, which becomes a border point. K remains noise, L remains noise, and same as before, M becomes a noise point for the moment. We then check O and see, okay, O is a core point. We check R, or R is a core point. And we see, okay, T only has R in epsilon range, so T, T becomes a border point, as do all the, Q becomes, of course, a core point because there are three points in epsilon range, and all the other points do as well. Okay, and there's our clusters. Now we have epsilon 1.1 and midpoints 4. Well, none of our points fulfill, no. Only two points fulfill this, so everything else becomes noise up until the point where we reach. Oh, it's not only 2 points. H, of course, fulfills this because we have 4 points in range of one, making G, I, and J border points. K and L remain noise points, and then M becomes a noise point for the moment. We check O, O becomes a core point, making M a border point. R becomes a core point, and all the others are border points. Okay. And here's our clusters. In this case, only two. And then we increase our epsilon range to 2.1 and min points 4. So we add B, C, and D to our seed list, and then just continue with those, all of them being core points, E still being a noise point, and F being a noise point for the moment, then G, H, J, and I becoming core points, and something that you can immediately see, K is in range of J now, making K a border point for the second cluster. L remains a noise point, and all points in the third block here become the core points of the third cluster. Okay. And as you can see, our cluster range has now increased, of course, since we have an epsilon of 2. Okay, now we work with an epsilon of 4.1 and min points 5. That makes the should make the entire corner at the bottom noise points for the moment. We will see if they remain those. And it seems that's not the case. D will become a core point, making E a border point. Okay, in being in our epsilon range. So as you can see, our E point is also in range of F. And depending on the implementation of our algorithm, E would now either belong to our second cluster here, or to our previous first cluster. As you can see, L is also in range. And since making L a border point here, which is important, even it reaches points of our second our probable third cluster here, but isn't close enough to be a core point, and therefore becomes a border point, and doesn't have enough points in epsilon range to be a core point, and therefore we then check M and the rest, which becomes our third cluster. Okay. And here's our cluster borders. Okay, and the last one, range 4.1 and min points 4. That will look rather similar, of course. The bottom will become a full cluster again, with not only D being a core point. Top will become a full cluster, K will become a border point. Well, okay, no, K starts out as a border point, we then see, okay, there's 5 points in range, K therefore becomes a core point. We then check L. L has 4 points in range, in epsilon range, means it's still a core point, and what was previously 2 clusters are now 1, having these cluster borders. Okay, and that's it for exercise 9.2.